Hey guys, in this video we'll see how to perform testing in Jetpack Compose. We have written two tests for our compose. So first is the screenshot and other is the to-do compose. Let's run the to-do compose test. So this basically comprises of five tests in all. So first is the test for add to-do. Second is the test if title exists. Third is the test for to-do input field. And the fourth is test for not saving to-do. So, and we can see all our tests are passed. Let's run the screenshot comparator test. So this basically compares the screenshot with the golden screenshot which we have already. And yes, we can see the test is passed. This is our first test file called as to-do compose test. So here basically we have initialized a compose test rule using create compose rule. So create compose rule is basically helpful for testing compose libraries as specified in the Android documentation here. So we'll make use of this. Since our app uses a navigation controller, we would set up it before running our tests. This is done using test nav host controller, which offers the navigation APIs for testing. Our first test, test if title exists. Here we set the content to home view. This set content comes out of the compose test rule, which we initialized earlier, and is useful for setting a given composable for that starting point of your test. Finally, using the on node with text, we compare that the text, which is title underscore main, is present on the composable, which is home view in our case. On node with text basically finds the semantic node with the text, which is title main. And if we look in the file, title underscore main is this. So this text should be present on the composable screen. As we can see on the home view, we have my to-do list and hence the test passes. Next test is for the add to do click. So in this test, we set our compose to navigation component, which is the parent component in our case. Next, we click on the on node with text, which is add to do, and we perform the click. Perform click basically performs the click action on the node specified. So in our case, we have specified add underscore to do. And if we look in the constants file, which is, so this add to do is nothing but add space to do. So in our compose screen, when we find this element, this should be clicked. Once the click is performed, then the add to do will navigate to another screen, and which is what we are testing in the next rule, which says if the text found is saved to do, and if it exists on the screen, that means our test should pass. And what is saved to do? Let's see here. So this is nothing but the button or the text save to do. So in this test, basically what is happening is the test clicks on the screen and it performs the click action on add to do, and it lands to this screen and it checks if there is a node with save to do text. So we have this save to do here, hence this test passes, and we can see on the left hand side. Next test, which is the test for not saving to do. What we do is we set the initial compose to navigation component. Next, we check for the add to do and we perform the click on it. Since on the click of add to do, it goes to the new screen, which comprises of the save to do, and we check if it exists. Next, we use espresso to click on the system's back button. This is the description of this back button. So this basically performs the back button click. The back button is pressed. We again go back to the add to do screen. And finally, we check if in that screen a node with title underscore main exists. This title underscore main is nothing but the text with my to do list. What happens in this test is basically we click on the add to do. So then it goes to this screen, which has the save to do. But it presses back, and finally it checks if this screen has this title main, which is my to-do list. The final test for our to-do compose is test for to-do input field. So in this test, we set our initial compose to the add view screen. Next, we have some dummy text, which is also called as dummy text. Next, we check for a node with the tag as test input tag. And if it exists, then we perform the text input with this dummy text. This on node with text basically identifies the node with a given tag. And this perform text input basically sends the text, which is tummy text in our case. Finally, we verify that the text entered is basically equal to what we have in the input field. On running this test, basically what happens is the compose add view is launched, dummy text is entered, and it's verified. If everything works, the test is successful. In this test, what we do is basically we compare the golden screenshot, which is add to do, and if we see add to do, this is the add to do screenshot. So this screenshot is compared with the composable screen, which we'll see. Since we use the navigation controller, we again set up it using the test nav host controller. And we have only one test in this file, which is the test add to do screen. In this test, we set up our initial compose to add view screen. And next, which is we compare the add underscore to do, which is this file, with the compose test rule on root. This on root is only used for screenshot testing. So in our case, we have set the compose to the add view, and hence that is being compared to the add to do. Assert screenshot matches, what we do is we capture the current screen as a bitmap. Then the next step is we save the screenshot of that bitmap in the application cache with the name and the current millisecond time. If we look at the device file explorer, so this is our app. Inside this, we go under files and we can see the screenshot captured as add underscore to do with the timestamp in milliseconds. Next, we open the golden, which is our basically the assets and this add to do using the instrumentation registry. And finally, this golden is compared with the bitmap or the screenshot we saved. So in this test, it launches the screen with add view. It takes the screenshot, it compares with the golden, and if matches, the test is passed. That's it from this video, guys. Source code and article links are mentioned in the description below. And thanks, guys, for watching.